What up, y'all? This is my first vlog ever. I really don't know what the fuck to say, but we going to the box office at the Kia Center in Orlando to see if we could get a cheap ass ticket for the Travis Scott concert. I was looking at Ticketmaster today, and the tickets are going for around like 50. I mean, it's like 57, but you know how like Ticketmaster be taxing, so that shit comes out to like $70-$80. So I want to see if at Kia Center at the box office they're selling it for cheaper. It's 5:10 right now, and the box office closes at 6. So I'm a little worried that I'm not gonna get, I'm not gonna have time, but I'm 23 minutes away, so I should be straight. I should be like 30 minutes before closing, so we should be good. We should be good. But this is my first ever vlog, so I feel a little weird. I don't even know if I'm gonna really post this on YouTube, but we'll see. I honestly don't know. I just feel like vlogging today, so I'm just doing it, maybe starting it. I do want to, like, for this channel, like, I really don't have anything posted. I only have like three or four videos posted, and they just been concert videos, and then like a clothing video I made when I went to Dover Street Market in New York. But I really want to start this channel up and make more concert video, getting media passes and all that for concerts. And I just want this channel to start like super small and then see my progress on how big I can get, even like starting to do tours, get into like Rolling Loud, all of those festivals. So you're probably not gonna see a lot of big artists at the beginning of my channel start, but you know, it's just my process. You gotta just trust the process. We gonna get up there one day. I'm gonna probably do like a lot of local spots and just build my way up from there. Yo, so oh shit.
Miami's Daily Traffic.
Yo, so I'm entering traffic right now, and I'm getting a little worried. It says I get there now at 5:46. I have no idea where to park. I'm a little worried. If anything, I'll come back tomorrow, but the dude said he's not for sure if the same price is gonna be there tomorrow, because tomorrow's the actual day of the concert. So we'll see, bruh.
She's not my girl. She's not his girl.
Good news, and I mean bad news, if anything. The dude was looking at the tickets through Ticketmaster, so it made no difference. But the good news is that he did get me the cheapest one, which was the $37 one, that I couldn't see on the app this morning. Like, they completely removed those off the app for some reason, but on the computer still showed. I don't know what was the difference. I guess they have more of like a access to it, but yeah. So over there's gonna be the GA entrance for people that are on the pit. And then ain't it crazy, bruh, that they got a Webster University right next to where he's about to perform? Like, Jock the Webster.
Shut your bitch ass up.
What? Ooh, it's time, baby. It's time. Oh, oh. Damn, I forgot what I was gonna say now. I'm too hyped. Damn. I'm chopped right now. First of all, I gotta get ready. Let's see what we about to put on. I got two. I have two shirts I could wear to this. I got this one. Something light. I could wear this, right? Let me put this over here. Right? Something light. Or I could hit them up with this one. Sheesh. Like, this is an actual Travis Scott shirt. Because honestly, this one, I'm going to be so for real, bro. It's a rep. It's a rep, bro. It's a rep. But we don't talk about it. And then for jeans, I'm feeling black.
Like my man.
Or I could go with the beige. If I hit up this shirt, I feel like it's only right if you go beige, no? I don't know. We'll see. I'm gonna try on my fit. Another thing, I hit up my stepsister's coworker, and he got the whole game plan. He got like three different ways of trying to get into the GA. So today's just gonna be a mission of just trying to get into GA. So let's see how much I vlog today. Everything's gonna be on my phone, which sucks. I wish I could take my camera, but they don't let cameras in. So whatever, man. I'm gonna get ready now, and I'll show y'all my fit real quick. And then we'll be on our way from there. Y'all just gonna see the rest from there. All right, guys. This is my, this is the OOTD.
What the hell?
OOTD. We got the Reeboks on. You know what I'm saying? These are my mosh pitting shoes since they dirty already. We got the Cactus Jack Jordan collab going on here. Clean. Yes, sir. We got the necklace going on. Stop playing with them. We're gonna be looking clean. We in the VIP section. Yes, sir. We in the whole VIP section. Okay, so before we even get any further, let me explain to y'all how I even got to the VIP section. Yes, this is gonna be a story time. If y'all don't wanna hear my story time, then y'all could go watch somebody else's video. I don't care. This shit was legendary. So I gotta explain detail by detail everything that happened, cause I just need this as like memories. So basically what had happened was I end up meeting with the group I'm going with, right? And two of the people we were with were not aware about us going to GA. They were just like, what the fuck? We about to sneak into GA. And then we're like, hell yeah, we about to sneak into GA. You better be ready because our plan B is to hop over the gate. Because if we can't get in through the main entrance for GA, we're hopping that shit. And they're like, all right, bet, we down. So luckily they were down for the plan, right? And so one of the other dudes we were with, he already had researched like which wristbands they were using for that show. And the wristbands were basically like just like green stars. It was a white wristband with green stars on them. We ended up going to the parking lot and they were just drawing the stars. This is the picture of the wristbands. It looks kind of bad, but at nighttime they look real. Like they actually look like they legit, right? Boom, we're at the arena and hella people there, hella people. Like the place is packed, right? And we're just asking people, like, yo, is this the GA entrance? They're like, nah, the GA entrance is on the other side of the arena. So we walked to the other side, and the queue for the GA is dead. So everybody that had GA entrance already got in. As soon as we get into the queue line, there's a security guard literally standing right there, making sure that everybody that is not GA can't go inside. Luckily, there's some other kid trying to sneak in, and she stopped him first. And so we kind of went like to the side of her, like facing her back, and we just went like across. But she noticed that it was like a group of people just crossing by. So she looked back and she was like, hey, y'all gotta show me like y'all tickets. And we just went like this. We're just like, we got a wristband on. And we went super fast. We're like, we got a wristband on. And she completely went silent on us. And she was like, oh shit, okay, whatever. So she let us through, right? And we thought we were set. Like I thought, like when that happened, I thought I was like, okay, bet, like, hey, we said like we don't have to show tickets no more. She thought that we were actually supposed to be there because we showed our wristband, right? So we get to the security line, like we putting our wallets in the bucket, whatever, pass it down, go through the metal detectors. And then the guy's like, enjoy the show. I'ma enjoy the show, trust me, I'ma enjoy the show. And so after that, when you see me like going into the door, is where there was like hella security. That's where they were like actually scanning the tickets themselves. And the security there was just like, nah, bro, y'all gotta show us like the real thing. Like it can't be just a screenshot. And mind you, we made up a story beforehand just in case this happened. We just said our friend Loaf and Adam are inside the GA and we had to go back to leave our hoodies. And that's why, like, we were already inside. Like, we already had a wristband on and everything. Like, we already went inside. Lowe's and Adams were the ones that have our ticket, and they sent us a screenshot of the ticket. And bruh, let me tell y'all, bruh, here's the pictures of the ticket. This is like the Photoshop ticket. Does not look that good. It's super blurry. The security did not believe it. She said that's BS. Like, hell nah. So I kind of got a little pissed because I was like, yo, so then what's the point of the wristband? Like, I was trying to pressure her, whatever. But that was their security. They wanted to do the scanning. And, you know, I can't be mad at it because they're doing their job, right? We end up heading back and we're like, damn, all right, plan A failed. So we had to go into the regular entry. That's the merch line. I'm trying to get back to my crew. Plan A was a failure. Plan A was such a failure, but we're gonna see if we can get into this now. We're like on the second row of the 100 section. So I see these two kids in front of me, and I asked them in the front row, I'm like, yo, like, y'all about it? Like, y'all wanna like hop the gate? And they're just like, nah, bro, we actually paid for these seats. We're not trying to do anything like that, but I'll let you hop over if you want. And I'm like, hell yeah, let me do it. Like, and he's like, yeah, I'll just scoot over. Like, when the show starts, I'll scoot over, and all you gotta do is hop over. And I was like, bet. So the whole time, I'm eyeing each security guard that's there, and I was just counting them down, and I was trying to make sure that I could just like sneak in through one of the gaps when the show starts. I'm doing all this stuff, and the people that were supposed to sit where we were going to sit came over, bro. I was just pissed, bro. I was like, nah, this ain't it. So we started going back upstairs, right? And a little side story to this, which I didn't record, I wish I recorded it, but we ended up meeting Danny Towers. Danny Towers was actually there. If y'all don't know who he is, I'm gonna play a quick clip.
Danny, how you feel?
I feel great. I'm in that water, I'm from Florida, but my wrist Cuban.
Whatever. That's just a little side story. It is a pretty cool side story. But then, boom, right? We're walking all the way back upstairs. As we're walking upstairs, there's like the VIP balconies that are like across, right? And there's these kids, like they saw us like just like huddled up, like planning, like, all right, what's the next section we going to? And the kids upstairs, they're just like, yo, y'all ready to get lit for Travis Scott? And we're like, hell yeah, we're trying to get lit, what the hell? Because he was talking to my boy. I tell him, I'm just like, yo, like, can you tell him to, like, if we could hop over, like, if we could just get into the VIP section? And he was like, oh shit, I didn't even think of that. And then he told the kid, he was just like, yo, like, you think we could hop over? And he was like, damn, I don't know if we could do that. And then his boy that he was with in the VIP section was just like, bro, fuck it, let him do it. And he's just like, fuck it, bro, do it, come on, everybody jump. Without hesitation, we all jumped that shit. We all whoop. It was literally like it's like the soldiers when they're like grappling up a mountain or something, and it's just like a stack of just them like going up. That's literally us. Mind you, it's five of us doing this. No security saw us, plus some other two kids that saw us doing it also jumped in without like any invitation, nothing. They just hopped over, right? So it's like seven of us in this VIP section, and we just chilling there, and the show's about to start. All I hear like is people chanting, Kanye, Kanye. And I'm just like, bro, these people really think it's gonna be Kanye? Like, y'all really that like delusional right now that it's gonna be Kanye? You really think Kanye's gonna come to Orlando? I had doubts. I was like, bro, Kanye's not going to come here. You know, like, I thought it was gonna be Drake, and everybody thought it was gonna be Drake, only for the fact that Drake has a show. He has two nights in Tampa this coming weekend. So everybody thought, since he has to come for rehearsal, he's also gonna be here for the last show for Travis Scott, because it makes sense, right? Bro, everybody starts chanting, Kanye, Kanye. And I'm just like, what's happening? So I'm on Instagram at this point, right? I'm just like, what's happening? I see a photo of Kanye in like a security cam, which, like, it's not like anything that big of a deal, but it looked like the arena.
Bruh, tell me how. He literally put one that it said you took like Circus Maximus Orlando sold out. The wall. And we all start freaking out, bro. I'm freaking out because at this point I'm like, there's no way I'm about to see Kanye West tonight. Like at this point, I'm like lit. Like I'm having the time of my life and the show hasn't even started. And I'm gonna play y'all the clips now. I'm gonna stop talking. There's still more, but I'm gonna play like the beginning of the show and a few other clips that I got there and then like the live stream.
Chase B, it's Orlando versus everybody in this motherfucking universe.
Alright, so then that's that, right? And so while I'm live streaming, I'm over here live streaming the show, and all I can hear in the back of my ear is some lady go like, yo, y'all gotta show me y'all real tickets. So I just see everybody getting like taken out one by one, and I'm just there like, damn, you know what, I'm gonna just pretend like I'm here. So I start like singing, I'm like going crazy, I'm just recording, I'm like singing every song. But nah, bro, that didn't work. The girl started tapping on my shoulder and I was just pretending like she wasn't like I wasn't feeling anything. And so then she started tapping me even harder and I'm like, what? And she's like, And so the girl, like, I'm telling her, I'm like, bro, I got a wristband on. I'm supposed to be here. And she's like, I can't hear you right now. You got to go outside, like, to talk to me. And so I'm like, all right, bet. I'm walking outside. And the whole group I was with was just like, yo, we got to go. We got to dip. So everybody starts, like, jogging outside. And we end up, like, running into the bathroom. And so in the bathroom, we're just trying to make another game plan. We're like, damn, like, what should we do now? Like, we don't even know what to do. And the two kids that led us into the VIP section also went into the bathroom. And we're just like, yo, what happened? Like, why they kick y'all out? And we're just like, you tell me, bro. Y'all people snitched on us. What the fuck? And we end up, like, we had to, like, leave the bathroom at one point. So we end up leaving the bathroom. There's, like five security guards just waiting for us outside the bathroom. And they're just like, yo, we got to see y'all real's ticket. We didn't say a word back to them. We were just sprint walking out of the VIP section. Did not say a word to them, just walk. As we were walking down, I made a right. And mind you, I'm in the front of the group. Because I was low-key pissed. I was just like, bro, I'm not missing this show. And he's playing, like, I could just hear Mamacita playing outside. Because he's, like, playing all the OGs. And I'm just like, damn, bro, no, I'm not missing this shit. So I'm, like, sprint walking out of the VIP section in the front. I end up making a right into, like, where the staircases were. And as soon as I hit the staircases, I booked downstairs. And I noticed that, like, when I went downstairs, there's a room. I walked into the room. And there is hella security there again with the metal detectors. And it said floor GA section. And I was like, damn, this is the floor. And I couldn't book it because there's so much security there. So then I was like, damn, all right, I'm gonna go back. As soon as I look back, my whole group is gone. So then now I'm going back and I'm sneaking into the 100 section, right? I'm back into the 100 section. And at this point, I'm gonna show y'all the footage now of this. But I have a footage of me, like, going, like, I'm about to hop this. Like, I'm about to jump. Like, I'm about to hop the fence. Because at this point, I'm just like, damn, I'm tempted. Like, if I'm alone, I'm going to do it myself. And so, at the very end of that clip, I don't know if y'all could notice, but there's a flash that goes off at the very end. Like, two flashes. And I immediately stopped recording only for the fact that the security that was in the pit saw me. And he knew what I was trying to do. And so he was flashing me with his flashlight. And he was like, you gotta go back upstairs. You gotta get out of here. And he was like flashing me like in the face. So I was just like, nah, bro. Like, I'm not gonna try shit. So I'm going back upstairs. And so I see this guy like kind of like scoot into like the staircases. And I just go like right like behind him. Like, I'm just there for the rest of the show. And Travis Scott starts playing Praise God.
Even if you are...
And I'm like, oh, it's time. He's coming out. Because we all know, if you know, you know, right? If you know, you know. And he starts playing Praise God, right? And so, yeah, he plays that. And no Kanye whatsoever. And I'm just like, nah, there's no way. No way we just got bamboozled. There's no way. There's just no way. And out of nowhere, all you see is Travis kneel down on the floor. And all you hear is that. Oh my God. Oh. Oh my God. I'm telling you, bro. It was like he played that one note. And that's what makes Kanye so legendary. Because he could just play that one piano note. And the whole stadium is gonna collapse. Like, the whole stadium. There's not one artist that could play a single piano note and the whole stadium just starts going nuts. So he plays that, right? I'm going crazy. And I'm gonna play y'all the footage right now. Like, I'm gonna stop talking because the rest is history. And I'm gonna play y'all all the clips. The rest is just history after this.
Oh my God.
It's Orlando, join up, Chase B. What the fuck you got for me, you dig?
In the way. It's all like this!
Young love is baby!
Oh my God! Oh my
God! Young love is baby! I'm feeling it's fade. No one in the world. I'm feeling it's fade. I think I'm getting so much. Ain't nobody watching.
I just
made the
one.
Playing classic after classic after classic, and I'm going nuts. Like, I'm going absolutely nuts. Like, I'm literally like you could see me, I'm saying like, this is historical, this is the most historical thing. Because mind you, I've seen Kanye before, but the when I saw Kanye, it was for Donda 2, and he only played exclusive music. Like, it wasn't like he played any of his classics, but bro, he played all his classics with bro, and I was just going insane. Like there was nothing in me that was stopping me, right? And tell me how he's like playing Vultures, and out of nowhere, bro, like as he's playing Vultures, the security guard behind me starts tapping on my shoulder. And at this point, like in my head, I'm just like, ain't nobody. They gonna have to bring out the whole gang on me to drag me out of here. Like, y'all gotta have to drag me out the stadium if y'all want to kick me the fuck out. Y'all gonna have to bring out the whole SWAT team on. So I'm just there, and she's tapping on my shoulder, tapping. She's like, hey, hey, hey. And she's screaming at me. And I look back, I'm like, what? And she's like, scoot in, scoot in. Like, she's just telling me, like, scoot in so, like, I could let people, like, walk through, like, the staircase. I'm just like, oh, okay, bet, bet. But I low-key got scared because I thought she was gonna take me out. After that, like, Kanye left, and Travis just played, like, more of his music. He started playing Fiend, which I started going crazy. I'm gonna play y'all, like, all the like, times he played it. He played it, like, 10 times, maybe. But, yeah, I'm gonna just stop talking. Here's the rest of the clips.
Yeah. That's the only way to do it, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm raging. My eyes could have been closed, and they could have had you down here in the stove. Because you're being fucked by.
Come on, baby, why? I'm in the pick up truck, pick up up with get those goosebumps every time.
I just want to say one thing. I'm overly thankful. I'm overly thankful for everybody that supports me through everything I go through. A lot of people thought I was crazy to put a tour up, and I'm just thankful that my fans show up and show out every time. And I'm thankful that I was able to make it through this tour. I love you guys so much. I'm honestly nothing without y'all. This is nothing without y'all. It's the fans in the flame for fucking ever. I love y'all so much. Chase B, let's take it the fuck out of here, baby!
Alright, Chase, we turn it back up so I can finish this motherfucking thing. You know the future.